This time, I went to a supercomputing conference and helped build the world's fastest temporary network. First, let's do a quick recap of what I saw at the exhibition floor.
Mobilint MLA100 is an AI accelerator card. Here you can see it performing real-time classification on all of the images while using less than 50 watts of power. Cool IT presented their cooling solutions. Here you can see the cold plate of their design. You could spot Nokia having their 7730 SXR out in the open. It's a router running Acer Linux capable of handling 400 gigabit interfaces. Dell presented their lineup of servers, and since Nvidia didn't have their own booth, every major vendor was shilling out for them. I especially like the supposedly confidential quantum stuff. Quite a bit of immersion cooling solutions, single and two-phase. Exadrive showed something that I thought is an 11 out of 10 idea. An SSD drive with both SATA and USB-C connectors, in case you want to take the drive with you and share files quickly. Finally, a supercomputer. Bull Sequana from Atos allows you to pick and choose your own blades while configuring the system. You can see their interconnect module, Intel-based blades, and AMD-based blades. More accelerator cards. This time ProDesign mainly showcasing their FPGA card based on Intel Agilex chip. Supermicro with their monster of a GPU server. This one is meant not only for HPC and AI, but also for cloud gaming. Notice the cables connecting GPU board to the CPU motherboard. Check out how those 256GB modules from Micron are just two sticks glued together. Another Intel FPGA, this time from IR, showcasing 400 terabit per second optically enabled device. You could spot ARM servers with Nvidia cards. Here I'm taking a closer look at Bluefield 3 DPU. Again, 400 gigabit connectivity is becoming a standard for those types of servers. They also had the Grace Hopper superchip on the display. That thing is gigantic. HPE presented their Cray AX4000 system, which is super densely packed and fully liquid cooled. This is a blade you can get for it. Single unit can be fitted with 8 APUs.
Obviously, I haven't told you about everything, like for example top 500 update. But that's because I was busy building this.
This was the world's fastest temporary network. Past tense is intended, as it's already disassembled. This network is designed, tested and built by SCinet volunteers. It provides connectivity to the whole showroom floor, from Wi-Fi and commodity 1 gig booth connections to 400 gig uplinks used for network research exhibition. Designing and deploying high-performance network with multiple vendors poses several challenges. Interoperability issues between different vendors can be a major hurdle, requiring meticulous testing and configuration adjustments to ensure seamless integration. Moreover, troubleshooting becomes intricate when dealing with different vendor-specific protocol implementations and configuration know-hows. As you can imagine, there are quite a lot of teams involved in this process.
I am the part of the routing team.
So, how does one build such a network?
We start in February.
And while not all architectural details are fleshed out at this point, we discuss what new solutions or ideas we would like to implement this time. As soon as we have a general idea, we hop onto our GNS networking lab. Acquiring appliance images used to take quite some time, but now that we have most of the vendors covered, we can start building whatever topology we want anytime. We have until November to test and flesh things out. It might seem like a lot of time, but remember, we're doing it either after hours or sparsely during work. We push through, and then before you know it, it's almost November.
Let's talk about this network for a second.
At the very top you can see internet providers. Some connections are direct fibers routed throughout the USA. They all come down to the Polatis, which is an optical circuit switch device. From there, we connect to our four main routers. Three of them are called NOC routers and one of them is a conference router. The conference router, which on the diagram is named Conf Router Juniper, is an MX304 box and provides, among many other things, internet access for Wi-Fi and streaming services. The NOC routers are responsible for handling their own subsets of internet routing tables. Those are pretty beefy devices outfitted with one of the fastest optics available on the market right now. The NOC routers are connected via LACP to the border leaf. It acts as a gateway between our NOC routers and EVPN VXLAN fabric. Nokia and Cisco spines provide route reflecting capabilities as well as redundant paths for DNOC underneath them. The DNOCs are small booths placed around the showroom floor. They contain one switch for commodity 1 gigabit connections, one switch for 10 gigabit connections, and a perf sonar server used for monitoring. Only from DNOCs, fiber is being laid out to the exhibition booths. If you are wondering, what about 100 and 400 gigabit connections? They are connected directly to the border leaf. I've mentioned EVPN VXLAN. Those are two technologies that work together to create a scalable and flexible layer 2 overlay network over an existing layer 3 network. The EVPN VXLAN fabric spans from border leaf down to the DNOCs.
Explaining EVPN and VXLAN would be a whole another video at this point, so if you're interested in that, please leave a comment. Now that you have a general idea of how this network works, we can proceed to what SCinet has achieved at SC23.
6.71 terabits per second connectivity provided to the convention center, 206 volunteers, $40.5 million of equipment donated and loaned in hardware, software and optics, 20 kilometers of fiber deployed, 421 wireless access points deployed.
We really could skip that one access point, I know.
But that's a general overview. We have also widely implemented IPv6 and used DHCP option 108, while also supporting legacy services via DNS64 and NAT64. Orchestrated and automated a lot of stuff using Cisco NSO. And deployed our own intranet solution.
Obviously, that's not all that can be said about SCinet, but my perspective is only that of the routing team member. I would also like to thank ICM and University of Warsaw for making this trip possible. If you made it this far, thank you, and I hope you'll stay for the upcoming videos on my channel.
This was DC Techie, signing off.